previous episode of Life is Strange.
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Whoa. What the fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone! Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
After staying up all night, I could use my rewind to catch a few more Z's, but maybe I better save my strength. Field Photo Memorial Wall.
Thank you.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed. Whoa. Hello, zombie face. This is what happens when you research quantum physics all night. This totally reminds me of being a kid in my room. Sorry, Mom. I am so not a rebel. I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom. It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games. Cartier-Bresson, Doisneau, Hamilton, the greatest. I could rewind for days and read all of these books. Will I really find any insight into my power? I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer. I could get lost doing time travel research. Me and the search engine have become one. If only I could be this focused on homework. Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. This is so insane, it sounds logical to me. This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can do what no scientist ever has. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. Should I sign? And I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around here. This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in my life. No smiling. Take your power seriously. Good morning, Lisa. Your leaves are lovely today. I may not have a green thumb, but I have a green finger. Drink up. It's got electrolytes. Now I have to wonder if any of these films are based on a true story. I'll miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds. Meanwhile, my guitar gently sleeps. Good morning, Chloe. I hope you slept well. Now, shall it be my Gucci shirt with the Vuitton jacket? Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again. Just because some ass pranked a girl's shampoo bottle and her hair fell out, we have to safeguard our toiletries. So, summer camp. Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now. Mrs. Hoyda is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing.
Courtney, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done.
Fine, I won't disturb you. Why would anybody even care? I thought artists helped each other. Two can play at this game, Moriarty. They might not believe it, but they won't be sure. One quick rewind, and I could stop this TP attack.
Ow! Ow!
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Why, hello again, Alyssa.
Okay, Max, that's twice you've saved me from a projectile weapon. Are you my guardian angel?
Hardly, I just have a sixth sense for trouble. I'm glad to help you out.
Blackwell has a surplus of assholes. Oh, by the way, Warren said you borrowed his epic film flash drive. I didn't know you were a sci-fi geek like us. What's your favorite?
I love Back to the Future, of course, but who doesn't?
Can you imagine going back in time to Blackwell in the 1980s?
We'd suffocate from all the hairspray.
You and Warren do know your sci-fi. Be careful, you might make Brooke jealous.
I'll just pretend I have no idea what you mean. The marks of Satan. Kate is an early bird. She might be up and gone. This is like the public DNA of our dorm. They live. Chloe is so determined to find you, Rachel. That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party. Trevor is making himself comfortable. Ugh, hope they don't get busted. I can't even imagine what life would be like being a cheerleader. Dramatic, I guess. Dana takes her Blackwell spirit seriously. I've never seen Dana this bouncy and happy without a pot of coffee. Curiosity killed the Max. Who will survive and what will be left of them? Don't say that out loud, dork. That would be fun to put skulls and ghosts all over Blackwell. Like I could pull this look off? Hello, Victoria. Speaking of Halloween, look at all this makeup. At least Dana knows how to use it. Hi, Dana. How are you?
Much better than yesterday. I'm glad we talked.
Me too. I know it's good to just talk about this stuff.
You're almost psychic. I felt like you knew everything anyway. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch, Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
Let's talk later, Max.
This is both sad and pathetic. Wake up, Max. Juliet is next to me in the hall. Not her room. Whatever they're watching must be hot stuff. Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
Are you sure? I thought you'd be pissed.
Not at you. Part of me was almost disappointed because I built up so much rage.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max.
That's so not cool.
I didn't get wasted on camera and get busy with the Vortex Club.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really?
Do you believe everything you...
Touché!
What did you do about Victoria pulling that crap?
Nothing... yet. My mind works in devious ways, too.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
There's Brooke, looking smarter than everybody. Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
Go away! People sleeping!
Clearly not a morning person. I'd love to make a photo collage of every person who've posted these. Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here. Thanks for the warning. Kate is not good. I wish David would get off her crack. As Chloe would say. Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up, and you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate or Max. She's a weirdo with that dumb camera. I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Is that the link to Kate's video? Damn, Victoria is so fucking mean. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it. Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode. Sorry, I forgot. I'm good to flow, thanks. No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book. Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed. Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal. My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there. No book here. And nothing here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. This is such a wise, wistful book. I have to read way more Bradbury. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. I need to get dressed before I go there. Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now. Oh, shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats. It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger. If I'm not already. I sure would like to catch this hall tagger.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her. Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week. Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night. Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now. Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty. Damn, it's the all-American zombie family. It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately. Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive. Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself? That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. Kate really has a doting father. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella. Hey, I'm trying to use my powers for good. That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy. Ouch. She left out Damnation. Good Lord. This must be Kate's H.R. Geiger period. Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles. Poor Kate. She doesn't look good.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
What about this video? And I swear I haven't watched it.
I can't even watch it, Max.
I won't either.
Thank you, Max. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
So why would you go?
Lapse of sanity? I just thought I could meet some new people.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Did you go?
Definitely not. I'm not sure where I went.
What do you remember about that?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag. So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened. Jesus, this is intense. If Kate wasn't out of it and is actually telling the truth? Yes, you should definitely go to the police, Kate. I totally believe every word you say. Nathan Prescott is truly dangerous.
Bless you, Max. I will go to the police, and also Principal Wells. With you as my backup witness, they'll have to take us seriously now.
Backup witness? Well, I mean, I believe you in everything, but we're still just spoiled punk students to the cops and faculty. I just think we need to be very careful here.
Why? Careful of what?
Nothing. Except the Prescotts are a powerful family. I hope this won't backfire on us, that's all. Even though that rich bastard has earned some serious bad karma. He'll get it. Time out, Max. You actually told Kate to go to the police and the principal, after getting a scary text threat. Now the police will definitely drag you into this shit. Jesus, this is intense. If Kate wasn't out of it and is actually telling the truth... The birds are flocking around Samuel. Ah, there's Samuel, up early, already communing with the critters. Hey, Samuel, you're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet, and I can feel the animals waking up with me.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me, like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there, except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Can't Blackwell have at least one no football zone? How hard is it to dump the trash into a bin? But I could use this to attract squirrels.
Release the Kraken!
Come on, squirrels. Time for your 15 minutes of fame. I better not get near the bench, or the squirrel won't take the food. Wowzer, it's hard to get this close to a squirrel. Yes! Another Pulitzer for the portfolio. I can see that Samuel's concerned, but does he need a poster? How did Samuel get photos of Rachel posing? I've never seen Samuel wearing shades. And what's with this other crap? I definitely won't play with this thing again. Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident, and too easy to sneak into. The paint job looks great. Samuel knows his color schemes. Hello again, Samuel.
Hello again yourself, Max.
Sorry to pry, Samuel, but why are there photos of Rachel Amber in your shed? I'm curious about her.
Sorry to pry, she says while prying. Now everybody wants to know about her.
So did you know her?
Like I told the police. She was a good egg. And she gave me those photos.
Oh, you talked to the police? Rachel wanted to be a model.
Yeah. She gave out headshots like squirrels chasing food. Keep on prying, Max. Sounds like you have a lot of time on your hands.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning, Rachel.
Of course you will.
I don't think I've actually seen Taylor alone without Team Victoria. Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk, for once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Taylor.
Conversation over.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to...
I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm glad we did.
Hi again, Taylor.
Hey. That wasn't such a bad talk. We should do it again. See you later.
Max, check it out.
Warren is out and about already, too. Looks like he's waiting for somebody. Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
Just a pirate I used to know.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star.
Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info. I have to tell Brooke I'm going with you to the movies instead. I'll text you later.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel. Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. She looks busy and stressed. Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
I bet he's seen a lot of changes to Arcadia Bay in his lifetime.
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
There's that dirty RV from the other day.
Stop that! Stop! No barking.
There was something creepy about that guy and his dog. Obviously, nobody took my advice. Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them. He looks like a photo of the classic Arcadia Bay crusty fisherman. Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
You have your own boat?
I call her the Bali High. I've kept a hold of her in these lean days. Might be all the time we've got left.
I thought one of Arcadia Bay's main exports was fish.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat. Until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay, if that tells you much.
Do you know them?
Too good for my working kind. I know them through their bad deeds. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there. That sign reminds me of so many times I ate here with Chloe and my family. When we were happy. I wonder if they explained that snow. Snow? Well, that's a good start to the story. Newspapers are going to be retro soon. Excuse me, sir?
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds!
The snow was pretty odd. It was right in the middle of a warm, sunny day.
Oh, global warming bullshit. It's the Northwest. Snow happens.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
You mean Rachel Amber?
I guess. I bet she ran away because she was bored. Who wouldn't be here?
Poor woman. I hope it's a shelter for her. Hello.
Aw, look at you.
A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. Has a daughter your age who's always in trouble. Married to a real prick.
Have you met Joyce's daughter?
Cute girl. Pissed off. I used to see her and her pretty friend, Rachel, around a lot.
Do you know anything about Rachel Amber? That missing girl?
I know she's missing. And I know she hung out here a bit. Sometimes I'd see her walking, all by herself, deep in thought. Too damn young and pretty to look so worried.
Was she alone a lot or with friends?
Like I said, she seemed tight with Joyce's daughter. I thought I saw her with an older gent one time. Maybe her dad. That's a terrible thing for a parent to deal with. I pray the poor thing is all right. But you can't save everybody.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
What changes to the town?
Ones it takes a lifetime to see. There's a lot of beauty here, but a lot of darkness, too. Greedy bastards that ruin this town, put people out of work. Out of home. Like me.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless, but Arcadia Bay is still my home.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
I have to go now. Goodbye. The smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again. Now that brings back memories. Chloe and I loved the parade. Good Lord, talk about apocalyptic. These fishermen are so damn quiet. Did you catch any big ones today?
If by big you mean none, then sure. I caught a lot of big ones today. Now let me mourn over my eggs.
I always wonder what people think about when they eat alone.
Hello there to you! Such a beautiful day, eh? Oh yeah, it's gonna be a super day. Enjoy your breakfast, eh?
Oh man, I bet that's the same gum from when I was here last.
Coming up at noon, K KBay7 News will explore the mystery of yesterday's unusual snowfall on a warm and sunny late afternoon that confused and delighted Arcadia Bay residents. We'll be talking with Portland meteorologists in the area and look at some of your fun video reactions to the odd snow flurry. Who knows? Maybe Mother Nature was pranking us all. So stay tuned to KBay7 News for the real story.
This guy has serious cojones. Why does that so not sound fun? I might make Chloe check this out with me. You'd never know how weird this town is by these postcards. I would buy a shirt, but they're so damn tourist. The poster doesn't mention whacked students with guns. That graffiti has been here forever. Gross. Thank you, redneck poet. Ew, that guy looks unpleasant.
What do you want? I feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
That officer looks nicer than wannabe cop David Madsen. Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard that Chloe even had a pot dealer in her room.
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell that loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. I'm just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
I wouldn't last one day as a trucker. Those rigs are too damn big.
I don't feel like talking right now. I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach. Over and out.
Truckers have such a romantic life. Always on the road. Hello?
Pardon moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
Good. I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
Justin is such a mellow dude. What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails. Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You crack me up, Maxer. Of course I'm baked, so I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up. He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, Max.
Trevor looks as happy as Dana did. Hey, Trevor.
Holla, Max. By the way, I know you saw me in the dorm.
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
Yeah, and I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was into her too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway. See you in class, Max.
Drool. Want everything. Forgot about the Fishing Wall of Fame. I got you, babe. How apropos. But no fucking way. That's funny. Our family never went whale watching. Looks fun.
She is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. Very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle, and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did, after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe must have changed a lot during that time.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did. And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
One Belgian waffle at 12 o'clock high.
I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. Oh yes, black coffee. You will be mine. Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
Order ready.
This is like fourth dimensional deja vu.
What kind of dive
is this? I keep going back in time.
Incoming.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl, but woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A bullet, just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
You need to look at the items and rewind so Chloe believes you. Okay, Max, study every item carefully and don't forget anything. You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind. So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. And now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That's the best song I've heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened. I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, really? Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. But he's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch.
Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever. You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened.
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave. Chloe finally believes me. And I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and people to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with, too.
Hey, Kate. What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now, let's rock.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate. It's not like I won't see her in class later. Pissed at me this week.
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back and she's also supersized?
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Are you kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
That's my Chloe. I have to find dirty-ass bottles while you chill? Not fair.
I have to prep the range, crybaby. And I've been tripping hard about where you got this rewind power.
From God? Or the gods? So, bow.
We can make the world bow. Are you ready for that?
No way. I still don't even know how my power works. Or for how long.
Dude, you fuck shit up, you rewind, you fix it. Drop the mic. Boom.
Spin, rinse, and repeat. I'm just altering time and space. Oh yeah, and history. No biggie.
You already altered history by saving my life, smartass. Let's see what else you can do.
Those shells look fresh. The Bigfoots were here. I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location. Oh, gross! So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Cool. At least not everything is broken around here. Hello, bottle number 1. 4 more to go. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. Hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time. Every car has its own tale and history. No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk. Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking. Stupid bottle. Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking. Maybe I can use this to reach the bottle. Where to find bottles? Maybe in an old refrigerator. Maybe I can use this to reach the bottle. Boom, only 3 bottles left. So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now. Hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students. It's hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students. Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone. I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine. This is the scariest thing. This rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth? They would have gone all the way to Los Angeles for a rave. Looks fun. I don't want to intrude, but I was here. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this? Oh, there you are, little bottle. Trying to play hide and seek. 3 down, 2 more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. Ouch. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. That kind of hurts. Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship? Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. I wish she named names. I better not show this to Chloe or she will be seriously hurt. Thanks for the tip. I'm sure this is a popular party pit. Oh yes, we can use this one for a target. One more bottle to go. Coming this fall, Max Caulfield, Bottle Hunter. Voila! Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe. I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars. Looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. That dough is the perfect photo op. She's staring at me as if we have a connection. This was an old school punk shirt. It's so quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something. I just have to figure out the message.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road.
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
Aim slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
Let's see you take a crack at that rusty barrel.
Sorry, Mr. Barrel. Your time has come. Listen to those fat bullet beats!
Aim at that old blue plank here.
I hate old planks. Give me something to shoot, Max.
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet. Old school.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
I want to see that windshield go down.
Watch out for flying glass! You guys better run for cover! Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Let's see what happens when you shoot the gas tank.
Step back. Gas tank go boom. Boom! Car definitely down, but no bottle casualties. Feels good, but I didn't hit any of the bottles.
Put a real dent in that front bumper.
Goodbye, cruel bumper. Jesus, I shot myself! Ugh, I shot myself! Back up, back
Stupid
up!
Gun? Hold on, Chloe.
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero! Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe. Look at her. Chloe can even chill out playing with a gun.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you.
Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girly? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now,
Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. That is hilarious. Oh, man. I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me.
Are you ready to do this?
We should jet before...
We have plenty of time to do anything we want, whenever we want. Make me proud, sister.
Come on, girly. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step-shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me. Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's...
Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me, especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Ah, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Like a superhero. Move!
Get me out of here, Max!
I need to pull the switching lever right now.
Hurry!
I can't even move it an inch. Maybe I can open this fuse box. Awesome, it's not locked. I better find a tool to cut those wires.
The train's coming!
I don't know. This looks way too heavy. And right over the switching lever. Damn! Something is blocking the drum.
Please!
lock the gun in place. I can't budget at all!
Hurry!
A crowbar! This is exactly what I need. I can definitely use this bad boy. Okay, what can I slice with this? In and out, no problem.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
I don't want to use this axe.
Please, get me out of here!
Good Lord, Max, she's not a zombie. Find another way. Maybe I can open this fuse box. Maybe an axe isn't the best precision tool for electronics, but which wire to cut?
Max, please!
Oh, stupid light! No go! Shit! But which wire to cut? Short Circuit City.
Get me out of here!
But which wire to cut?
Please!
Now that's the right cable.
Please!
Yes! I did it!
You okay? You saved me again! Crazy! Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn, that was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens. Because it can. And will.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. Little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
Like I would miss it. I have the sweetest outfit.
If I was normal, I'd be super excited about going to a major shindig. Justin always looks stoned. I wouldn't want to be at an end-of-the-world party with Nathan Prescott. Too much truth in advertising. It's the invasion of the Vortex Club. Maybe you owed money to Frank, too. You can really learn a lot about a school by the weird shit posted on the boards. Look at these trophies. Gotta give it up for those Bigfoots. They do stomp. Blackwell sure takes its swimming seriously. But otters are cute. Go otters. Zachary always looks like he's ready to throw a football. Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
I bet. As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that shit with the sext and Victoria.
It's over. Just another Blackwell mini drama.
You mean stupid shit. Man, I just don't get Victoria. What does she want?
Probably for all of us to talk about her. Like now.
Then let's not. You're pretty smart, Max. See you at the game Friday.
Desperate much? We're already here. I'm going to find out what happened to you, Rachel.
Hello, climate change.
Does anybody believe this shit? I should go and see what I can learn. If I was normal, I'd be super excited about going to a major shindig. Courtney will do anything for Victoria and the Vortex Club. Hey, Courtney.
Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I'm not anti-soiree.
You seem anti-fashion, though. A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Matt.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I'm sure the Vortex Club has a dress code. As you can see, I would need your advice on what to wear.
Thanks, Max. I didn't think you noticed high fashion. Tell you what, I'll put you down on the guest list, and before the party, I can give you some tips.
Cool. Thanks, Courtney.
I'll send you the party info later. Back to the list.
Join us or die.
So you can almost shoot somebody on Monday and party on Friday? Prescott power. Trevor surveys his domain. I swear, Principal Wells always looks distressed. Sir?
Oh, hello, Max. I hope this isn't about the alleged gun incident.
Alleged? Nathan did have a gun. Have you talked to him yet?
Yes, he's deeply upset about this accusation. I don't blame him. Once I have all the facts, we'll talk. For the moment, focus on your schoolwork.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy. Our head of security is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
I saw Mr. Madsen hassle Kate Marsh yesterday.
Wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
It's very easy for you to instantly accuse people of doing terrible things. Nathan, Mr. Madsen, who's next? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a meeting.
Sir?
Oh, hello, Max. I hope this isn't about the alleged gun incident.
No. Never mind.
Glad to see you weren't about to accuse another student of something or other. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Now, why would Frank Bowers have your bracelet? I should feel lucky to be here. If only I knew what David Madsen was really up to.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you. But it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
But you treat Kate pretty bad.
You step between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab. Luke is always using the phone as a shield to avoid people.
I saw Victoria and her friends shopping for the party.
That reminds me.
I really hope this jackass will use protection next time. Juliet is laying the smackdown on Zachary. I love how Evan is so above the Vortex Club and everything else.
Yo, Maxwell Smart. Talk later, cool?
Why? So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. Nobody does. Nobody.
Brooke always kind of pretends like I'm almost not there. Why?
Howdy, Brooke.
Hi, Max. Making your daily rounds?
How is your drone?
Miss Grant busted me flying it over the parking lot. She's all jacked up about surveillance bullshit. Like I was spying on Warren's new car.
You already planted a GPS on him?
I borrowed the one he has on you.
This can't
hate to hit
him hard,
but... Don't let me get in your way. So long.
I bet if I touch the glass, all these creepy sea critters will pop up. Or nothing will happen at all. Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher. Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max. Thanks again for taking a stand against camera surveillance here. Every signature counts.
How's your campaign going?
You signed the petition, now it's your campaign too. Thanks for stepping up. More people would rather send a text than sign a petition. That's how they keep us all distracted. Nobody will notice cameras on every square foot.
I know. I really hope you keep those cameras from taking over Blackwell.
Max, with students like you, we sure will.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must know Mr. Jefferson pretty well by now.
I certainly know him as a talented artist and terrific teacher. I've been here a little longer, but he's made a bigger mark. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
What about that snow yesterday? What's your scientific explanation?
Our climate is moving beyond explanation. Of course, some of the tribes here might see it different.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
There's Mr. Wizard hard at work.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer! Perfect timing! I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I have a vision. Go Diem.
Go Diem? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken. Sodium it is. Damn, zip, nothing, nada.
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell, so...
Asking me?
I have to add either...
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but... Go... Potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works... You get a free hug. Weird science.
Hey, Warren.
I have to add
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science. Yes! That was a blast! But let's keep it a professional secret. Cool?
Again we meet, Brooke.
This is true, Max.
I need to know if you can help me with a potassium experiment.
No can do, Max. I'm all about robotics, not chemistry. Give me a drone over a beaker.
I'm helping Warren with his latest experiment.
Oh, I guess he needed a neophyte assistant so he wouldn't be threatened. But you came to his rescue anyway.
Apparently, it's my nature.
Yet Warren ignores the experts right in front of him. Not that he would ask me for help anyway.
Hi again, Miss Grant.
Right back at you, Max.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are no dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
Neither, unless you want a face full of powder. I would add chlorine.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful, yet confused.
Maxwell Silver?
Asking...
Have that...
Wrong, Warren. You need to add chlorine. Not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it. Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
Oh, you guys really broke the bounds of science.
That was fun helping Warren. He's pretty cute when he's in full-on geek mode.
Check out the big brain on Max. You might be the next Heisenberg of Blackwell.
Wonder why they don't use real skeletons. I bet Mr. Jefferson has had to deal with a lot of troubled students. Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me? I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
It did happen. Nathan Prescott had a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on.
I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Yes. Sure, okay.
Stella is smart to stay out of all the drama. I guess I'm out of time to turn in a photo for the contest. Irony.
Then right. Show me the love.
How do I look, Taylor?
Alyssa really lives for her classes.
Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
Daniel is always on the outside looking in. What's up, Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on.
It's hard to not like Hayden because he just doesn't give a shit.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
Dana is ready for her 15 minutes of fame.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress. Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal.
No time to talk,
like
Max.
Like I give a
art
flying
progress.
Fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr.
I like Taylor's artistic side, not her personality.
Max is such a little...
Shh, I think she can hear us.
I can't believe the principal lets him stay in school after I told him what happened. Even if Victoria ignores me, I'm glad we talked yesterday.
Better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
You would know. Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down. We have a lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel.
I guess Kate will miss class now. Shot out all over the world for people to judge. I'm worried about her.
Usually. No smartphones in class, Max. Put that away. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. the shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mono.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down at the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
Is this for real?
It's flipped out.
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Kate! No! Oh, God.
She can't die. She can't. Not again. Not now. I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again. Yes.
Oh. What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself.
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
Are you serious? Thank you so much. The fact that you don't care about that video and would come up here to stop me means a lot.
I care about you because I believe you were drugged. We will find out who did this and make them pay.
You sound so persuasive, Max. If only...
Kate, I believe you. Will you believe me? Please, you don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No. Nobody cares about me. Nobody.
Kate, I saw that card from your father. You can count on him. He clearly loves you without question.
Dad does care, even though I hurt him. He's the only one I know who believes in me. I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody, but I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah. Real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen. As our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
I saw Mr. Jefferson talking to Kate right before our class. Then she ran off crying.
Mark, I do know that Miss Marsh has assisted you on class events.
Kate, Miss Marsh has been very withdrawn lately. I assume this awful video was the cause. I hated seeing the students laugh at her. She told me Max was the only one who believed her, would take her calls and actually listen to her.
She shouldn't have asked to be on video, macking with some dudes.
You ass! She didn't ask for any of this.
No, on the contrary. Max was right to bring this up. Now, I wanted to help, but I guess I was too late.
Well, now this is problematic. The publicity is rising, and perhaps you shouldn't represent Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes contest in San Francisco.
Are you serious?
I am. We don't need any negative press about that event. And we need to involve the Academy in possible disciplinary measures for you.
I understand. There are bigger things at stake than me. The life of a young girl, for one. Maybe you should investigate other staff members. Max told me she knew things about Mr. Madsen.
Let Max speak for herself. Everything we talked about here will be looked into. All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Mr. Madsen was bullying Kate.
Oh, grow up.
Excuse me, I was there. I saw you getting in her face.
You have no idea what you saw. Kate Marsh was involved with a bad crowd. I was trying to find out who.
Kate had a double life. I was super shocked when I found out.
No, you were part of the crowd. And like I said, I personally saw David physically harass Kate Marsh.
You lying little...
Shh.
Are you gonna take this junkie's word over your security officer? I know she smokes and deals marijuana.
That has nothing to do with Kate.
Max, falsely accusing other people seems to be a habit with you. I trust my security officer. I'll have to investigate to see if this accusation is true. Therefore, Max, I'm obliged to contact your parents and suspend you for a few days.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm with... Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate?
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and playing the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit. Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girl's bathroom?
Hey, that's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Careful, Mr. Prescott. I have been told of this alleged gun incident, and I have to admit that the video in question was sent to me by multiple sources.
Including me.
And since Mr. Prescott does appear prominently in the video and was responsible for the party, I have no choice but to suspend him until further notice.
Whatever. See you in court.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there. Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out, hugs, tears, applause. Like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it?
Just one and a half times.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, What do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I'll believe anything this week.